Fans, we're in the locker room and in the dressing room with the Midnight Express, Jim Cornette. Jim, what about the seatings for the Jim Crockett
Cup? What about the seating for the Jim Crockett Cup? Let me tell you, you know, I wish Jimmy Crockett was here. I wish his little Weasley self was here so I could shake his crooked, lying, cheating, tightwad hand. Now, let me tell you something. 1986, the Midnight Express were tag team champions of the world, and they said, well, no, the champions don't have to be seated number one. 1987, the Midnight Express don't happen to be champions of the world, so they say, the champions gotta be number one. Now it's 1988, Crockett Cup time coming up again. We've been undefeated U.S. tag team champions for almost 11 months. We were voted tag team of the year, so what do? They seat us number four, because Jimmy Crockett don't want us to have $1 million. He figure he can rip us off again. Well, let me tell you something. You got these Fantastics coming in here. Everybody's heard about them. Everybody's talking about them. Everybody's read about them. You want a main event match here at Jimmy Crockett? I know in that mind of yours, you figure that maybe, just maybe, they can bump us off and you won't have to have us to your tournament at all. You won't have to give us $1 million. Well, Fantastics, we're going to beat you for a couple of reasons. Number one, after this seating thing, number four, I got to show my mama that the Midnight Express ain't sitting on their butts. We're getting our part of the job done and we're getting ripped off. Number two, Jimmy Crockett, the NWA, you're going to find out how easy we beat these bums and anybody else you dig up. And Fantastics, number three, we're going to nip it, brother. We're going to nip it right in the bud. We're going to rain on your party before it starts, and we're going to show you that no other tag team can come in here to the NWA and try to steal our thunder. Just like the old West, the gunfighters, every time somebody was a fast draw, they had somebody coming up the hill every day trying to gun them down. Well, Fantastics, you better be real quick just to keep from getting humiliated and embarrassed as well as beat, because that's what you're going to be. You better have some standby matches, because this ain't going to take very long.
All right, fans, in a few moments, it'll be the Fabulous Fantastics and the Midnight Express right here.
submit one fall television time limit special challenge match. The opponent for the Midnight Express from the City of Angels, a combined weight of 420 pounds, Bobby Fulton, Tommy Rogers, the Fantastics.
Fans of Jim Ross, something that we have really been looking forward to, this match between the Fantastics, the Fabulous Fantastics. I tell you, their reputation has really preceded them, as we're going to get our first look at them. And we understand, fans, there's something to really behold in the ring. You don't want to take your eyes off of this match, because they're in against the United States champions, and what a combination they are. Fantastic in their own right. There they are, the Midnight Express.
Bob, the crowd here at the Scope Arena here in Norfolk, Virginia, a near-capacity crowd here in this great wrestling city. Privileged to see, along with the national television audience, the NWA debut of the Fantastics against the outstanding United States Tag Team Champions, the Midnight Express. And this young team, the Fantastics, no stranger to me, Bob. I've seen them wrestle on many occasions. They're a very dynamic team. A fast-breaking team, no doubt. And this will be a tremendous matchup. One fall or a television time remaining.
You're going to see four extremely athletic individuals in the ring that can really move and really get around that ring in a hurry. All four of them, extremely quick, very agile athletes. Beautiful Bobby, it looks like, is going to start for the Midnight Express. And for the Fantastic, it's going to be Bobby Fulton. Outside of the ring, that's going to give us Tommy Rogers and, of course, Sweet Stan. And, Jim, you know, we got two of the top 10 seeds right here in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. This very well could be the match that we'll be watching for the championship and the $1 million in that cup.
It certainly could, Bob. Arm drag takedown by Bobby Fulton. You're going to see that the Fantastics, Fulton and Rogers, are one of the quickest tag team combinations in wrestling today. And we both know, Bob, that that's one of the fortes of Jim Cornette's Midnight Express, is their tremendous quickness as well.
Well, you're 100% right, Jim, and that's one thing that they've relied on in their matches. In most all of their matches, they're able to outquick the opponents. That's always been to their advantage. That may be a disadvantage here. I got to go back, Iowa. You know, I sort of, in some respects, can agree with Jim Cornette about the seedings. After all, his tag team is the United States Tag Team Champions. Maybe they should have been seeded a little higher than number four in that Crockett Cup top 10 seeding.
Oh, another great arm drag. And Bobby Fulton got really deep on that one. And it's not very many men that you see that act quick, Bobby Eaton. But we just saw it with Fulton's quickness. Cornette may have a legitimate gripe. I don't really know. The seeds are made, a lot of criteria involved. Two of the teams that ranked ahead of the Midnight Express are currently not champions. That's what his gripe was.
That's right.
But you look back at one loss records, and you see that Dusty Rhodes and Nikita Koloff and the Road Warriors have the two of the greatest one-loss records in the sport.
100% right there on that, Jim. Here's the headlock now. It's beautiful Bobby. He's got that headlock now on Fulton. Applying that pressure. He's got him, I think, where he wants him. And they're right here, Jim. Speed will not be an asset as long as he can hold him. There's Stan. Beautiful move on the part of Fulton. Well, the Midnight Express, they thought they had him outfoxed on that move, and they saw that coming.
And to the ropes they go. There goes Fulton for the ride. The football tackle. And down goes Stan Lane. The Fantastics certainly looking like a tremendous team here, ladies and gentlemen. And we'll be back. Has really turned on the offense here, Bob. It's been Fantastics 100% of the way here against Jim Cornette's Midnight Express.
Well, it looks like the Midnight Express, Jim. They just haven't been able to get on track. As you said, the Fantastics, as quick and agile as they are, they've outquicked them. They've been a move ahead of them every time they've been in the ring. And now Stan is at an arm bar, and Rogers is putting the pressure to it.
They've outquicked them, Bob, is basically what they have done. They have outquicked the Midnight Express. As I mentioned earlier, that's something that we don't see very often at all, because that's one of their tremendous strengths, is their great quickness. But Stan Lane now showing some offense, but Tommy Rogers is fighting back here.
Fulton, Bobby Fulton tagged in, Stan Lane and Bobby Fulton. Two of the top 10 seeds for the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. These teams, along with 22 others, will attempt to survive in Greenville, South Carolina on Friday night, April 22nd. All 24 teams will compete, Bob. And as you said, this could be the finals right here.
Hey, you're 100% right as they're going to double team Bobby in the corner. Here comes Bobby Eaton high out of that corner. Oh, and did he pop that mat? He's going to go back down. He wants a little pause right here as he talks to Lane. And Stan Lane and Bobby Eaton now having a heated conversation, and I'm sure they're trying to figure out, how do you slow them down? What do you do to them? How do you stop that runaway express?
Well, one way is you can bury the right foot into the midsection. That's the start. That's just what Bobby Eaton has done. Eaton and Lane are a very resilient team. They're going to bounce back. You can bet on it. The Fantastics making their NWA debut approximately 1 month before the opportunity to win $1 million. It's a single elimination tournament. It's winner take all. It's not, there's no place or no show money. It's not a horse race. It's no going to be a horse race, but it all goes to
no second place. $1 million goes to the winner at the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Jim, right here, I am sure that Lane and Eaton, they didn't realize what they were in for. They didn't know what kind of a dogfight they were going to have out of these two. And Cornette, you're talking about a man pacing and a man on age. Edge, Jim Cornette is, he hasn't been still for a moment.
Stan Lane trying to come over the top, but on the other side, look on the other side there, Bobby Fulton, he shook the ropes and he's just relaxing a little bit. Tommy Rogers. Rogers now and Eaton back up both men to their feet.
Well, it's all been fantastic, but don't sell the Midnight Express short. They're United States champions and they're not that.
And tremendous competition. That's the true meaning of the National Wrestling Alliance, and you're seeing a tremendous confrontation between two of the top 10 seeds for, as Tony Schiavone and Jim Crockett alluded to earlier, the granddaddy of them all, Bob.
Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup, no doubt about it, Jim. It certainly is the granddaddy. And, you know, I've been sitting here watching this match, and I've been thinking about it too, Jim. Just how long can the Midnight Express go at this tempo? I tell you, that's been fast-paced all the way. The tempo has been up-tempo since the opening bell. It looked like that the Fantastics were going to try to run the Midnight Express right into the mat. That's what they're trying to do. Beautiful arm drag. Takedown again.
Well, people said that about the Boston Celtics and the L.A. Lakers. How much can they run? Well, they're going to run you into the ground. They're going to run you until the buzzer goes off in the fourth quarter. That's the philosophy of the Fantastics. They are in tremendous condition. This is their style. You will see this each and every time that they wrestle. They'd like to get it on. Kick it in gear, control the offensive pace, and that's what they've done against one of the toughest tag teams in wrestling today, the Midnight Express.
Again, he got Sweet Stan with an arm drag, and now with an arm bar, and each time, that arm drag has caught him by surprise. Jim, you talked about the conditioning and running him into the mat. Each time the Fantastics get into the ring and into a match, they always are certain and they're so sure that they're in better condition than their opponent. They're in better shape. They're going to be able to go 100% all out longer than are the opponents.
They really believe that, Bob, and they just added a little bit of an insult to the physical injury that they've been inflicting on the Midnight Express. Powerful football tackle by Stan Lane. And Lane held on, and now He's pretty happy with his ability as well, and he rightfully should be.
He was right happy about that, too. He felt like that he really caught him. Pulled him by surprise, and there was a surprise for the Midnight Express. Double backflip.
All 4 men in the ring, and this one is breaking loose here at the Scope. And once again, the Fantastics have control of the action. It's the Fantastics standing in the ring, and it's the United States Tag Team Champions who are taking this moment to regroup, and Jim Cornette is really upset with his team on the outside.
And the crowd again in the Scope going wild. It's what's happening to the Midnight Express. Look at Cornette. Cornette is irate. I don't think I've ever seen him scream and storm at his men like he's doing now.
Well, he was very animated, Bob, when you spoke with him in the locker room. But he is even more so at this point in time. It's like calling a timeout and getting your team over and having a little bit of a conversation.
I think he's dressing them down now. Yeah. Hey, you're dressing down your men here, aren't you, Cornette?
Well, Cornette's a little bit speechless, which is maybe a first.
Yeah, how many times have you ever seen that happen to Jim Cornette, that he was speechless? Now, Stan, as I say, don't ever count him out.
But you know, Bob, the Midnight Express are one high-impact maneuver, one high-risk maneuver away from getting control of this thing. But he didn't get it there. He went for the big elbow, but the quickness of Tommy Rogers prevailed on that occasion.
And that could have been the move that turned it all around. If Lane had landed that elbow, that could have been the thing that unlocked the door for them.
Pinning predicament here, lateral press. Look at Rogers has got the arm of Stan Lane Grapevine there, using his legs for leverage in both arms and his other arm. So this is a pinning predicament here that Lane's trying to bridge out of.
And that's taking a lot of strength out of Stan Lane as he gets free, runs to the corner quickly to make the tag. That arm drag again. Each time, either Beautiful Bobby or Stan Lane come charging into the ring, they run right into that arm drag.
That was an excellent tag. Great timing for Stan Lane, and Bobby Eaton would normally have had the advantage. But again, the tremendous quickness of Tommy Rogers once again stepped right to the front of the class. He had once again used the arm drag takedown to control the tempo. But right there, Rick, in the eyes, that's going to slow a lot of people down.
Bobby Eaton right under that as he leapfrogged right over Eaton now. Both the Fantastics in the ring.
Oh,
and they get him coming and going.
What a knee lift. Bobby Fulton almost knee lifted Bobby Eaton right out of his boots. Right out of his boots, I'm telling you.
Jim Cornette quickly around trying to give him an arm to help him in.
Cornette trying to... He's going to have to really do some serious regrouping here. The Fantastics.
They get to their feet. Fulton's going to go back to the corner, make the tag again. Here comes Rogers. What a move, and he turned around while he was in the air. That's how high he got on that. He got high enough just to flip right around in the air. Beautiful move.
These guys have tremendous athletic ability, and I have never seen anybody in wrestling execute a flying dropkick better than Tommy Rogers, but he was flying that time, and he flew right into the foot of Stan Lane. And now Jim Cornette perhaps can breathe a little sigh of relief, Bob.
Cornette sat down, and there's a karate kick again from Lane. And we talked about before, the one move that could turn it all around, and this could be it right here for the Midnight Express.
The karate kick right under the heart. Bobby Eaton, great move by Lane, great teamwork by Bobby Eaton. And now the reigning United States Tag Team Champions are taking over, and Tommy Rogers is hurt here. Pinning for Dibba, count of two.
Well, Jim, you know, and fans, you know, that a team like the Midnight Express, you can only hold them down so long, and they're going to turn it around on you. And that's what's happening right now.
I talked to the Fantastics at length. I hadn't seen them in quite a long time. Been old friends for a long time, Bob. They were really confident in their game plan. They were excited about being in the National Wrestling Alliance. match. And while we saw Jim Cornette's reaction before match time, he was irate. He was very preoccupied about the seating. Perhaps that has had a bearing on this contest.
And I was just thinking, too, that if Cornette and the Midnight Express, if he thinks the Midnight Express should be seated higher than number four, what about the Fantastics and their number seven seating? I think right now that they prove they belong right up there also.
Reverse chin lock. And Stan Lane encouraging his partner. And notice that the Midnight Express have slowed the pace down to a very deliberate tempo. And that is not their style, but I think they've realized they can't run, so to speak, with the Fantastics. They can't match them pace for pace.
They're going to try the different pace and the different style, and that's what it may take against these two. Next breaker by Eaton. You heard Jim Cornette right there, Jim.
I'm sure he's being very wishful thinking, very optimistic. A lot of punishment now being inflicted on Tommy Rogers. We know, Bob, from what we have seen, that they are great offensive wrestlers. We will see now what they're made of, because they're going to be, if the Midnight Express have their way, they're going to get some serious punishment right here.
He hooks the leg, had him almost in that cradle for the count of two. It's going to be time to see now, as you say, Jim, if they can gut it out. They're going to have to reach down deep and get it here.
Well, you got to hope that they haven't peaked, that their adrenaline is flowing so freely at the beginning of the match. And the Midnight Express took a lot of punishment. But a lot of embarrassment in the early part of this match. But, oh, what a hit, right hand.
He turned the lights out, at least for several seconds, on Rogers with that right. That one caught him right on the jaw and into the bridge of the nose. Look at Lane now. Beautiful move. He got behind him.
We had a pinning predicament, but we had a violent foot right to the face of Tommy Rogers. Rogers now is in serious punishment. The Midnight Express have had to slow it down to control the tempo.
Jim, it's interesting to note, too, that since they have done that, since the tempo of the match has changed, things have been a little different in the Fantastics' corner. They haven't been able to take control of the match nearly as much as they did in the opening minutes.
Well, what has happened, Bob, is that the Midnight Express have kept Tommy Rogers in the ring for an enormous amount of time. They have not allowed Rogers to tag Bobby Fulton. But there's a kick right to the solar plexus. And can Rogers make the tag? He is close. And yes, he does. Fulton is rested. And he has got fisted fire on the Midnight Express. Fulton, the legal man in the ring with big right hands. A lot of emotion.
He's double teamed.
They dropped him face first. Pretty predicament. This could be it right here. But Tommy Rogers came to his partner's aid.
Cornette has gone wild about that. Rogers quickly came in just in the nick of time. Got the foot into the back of Stan. It would have all been over had it not been for that.
Cornette thought that they had taken the shortcut that they needed and could wrap up the victory. But that's not how it worked. And Stan Lane viciously pulling the hair of Bobby Fulton. I'll tell you something. We said that this could be the finals of the Crockett Cup. The World Tag Team Champion seated number one. What are you doing here? They got him by the hair.
Swinging him by the arms and the legs to throw him halfway across the ring.
I thought they were going to throw him over the top rope.
It looked that way. Jim, as you said, fans, you're looking at two of the top tag teams in the world. You don't find them any better than this. Jim, you don't find any action any better than this either.
This is the National Wrestling Alliance, and there's no mistaking, it is the greatest there is. And on April the 22nd and 23rd, this is the kind of tag team action you're going to see, especially in Greenville, when all 24 teams will try to advance to Greensboro the next night.
Almost a pin again, a count of two.
Do these guys have a great heart, Bob? You've been doing this a long time. These two young kids, the Fantastics, have got great fighting hearts.
Suplex, hard to the mat again. Goes Fulton. Let's see, can he kick out? Eaton's going to hook the legs. Oh, he got that shoulder up. You're right, Jim. They dig down and get it every time. They show you what kind of hearts they got, fans.
He's bridging out with every ounce of strength that he has as Bobby Eaton is the, with everything that he has, is trying to secure the elusive pinfall for the United States Tag Team Champions. And this great crowd, here's the scope in Norfolk, really getting into this one.
Not only are the Fantastic showing you tremendous ability, great athletic ability, but they've shown you tremendous fighting heart, and that's what it takes to really be champions. Watch out.
Oh, man, right across his back. His neck was draped across the top cable. They may be waiting a little long. I thought they were going to try to pin him right there. Fulton's in dreamland right now, Bob.
Nice. And across the road, they're going to do it again. There goes Eno.
Oh, that's got to be it. This has got to be it. There's no way he's going to kick out of this one. One, two. His foot's on the rope.
Well, he couldn't kick out, but he got that foot on the rope. Look at Cornette. He's going wild.
He is absolutely going rabid.
He's like a lunatic around the ring.
Well, I think that this is a whole lot more than he thought it was going to be. I think he thought that the Midnight Express would just completely dominate this young team. But that is not the way it has been.
Eaton now, still with the arm, still putting the pressure as Fulton is face down on the mat.
You can bet that the other great tag teams, the other 22 teams that will be in the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup on April 22nd and 23rd are watching this one. They are scouting this because, gentlemen, it will be this intense or more with $1 million on the line in April.
They're all eyeing it. You can be sure of that. Power slam now by Eaton. He's going to go out of the ring. Oh, that top rope again. That's the flyer here.
If he hits it, it will be over. Elbow right to the chest. No way Fulton's going to kick out.
He did.
My gosh, he kicked. I ain't believing it. And it's a vault kick right to the face. And Eaton quickly makes the tag. But can you believe the desire, the tenacity, the fighting heart of Bobby Fulton to kick out? And Lane with a drop kick.
Standing drop kick by Lane, and he had the power of a mule in that one. Cornette right into the face of Fulton. Now it's going to cause Fulton to be double teamed again. Over the top rope he went. Back all the way over, out of the ring, down onto the concrete floor.
But the referee was not in position to see it. And in all defense to the official, Tommy Young is the next one official. He was with Tommy Rogers. And if you don't see it, I know you're a bottle official. If you don't see it, you can't call it.
That's right. No way he could call it.
You can't have a mystery call.
He certainly had his back to it. He was aware of what was happening. Rogers went up to complain and to call about it. Look at the crowd here in the scope. Tremendous crowd, and they're loving every minute of it. And I tell you, Jim, they're seeing a match that they're going to long remember.
It's great to be at ringside for the National Wrestling Alliance, and that's where you need to be, fans. There's nothing like seeing this action live. Big elbow to the chest of Bobby Fulton, and now the Midnight Express are cooking on all cylinders. They're tagging in and out, and they're keeping Fulton in that ring with no hope of a tag.
Well, they've got things going the way they want, and I think they've dealt out enough.
This may be his best match, but it's also going to be his last match.
Well, you heard Jim Cornette. He said he may be his best, but he may also be his last.
Cornette's face.
You said they were cooking on all four, Jim, and I think they are right now. But, again, I think the punishment that the Fantastics have taken has slowed them down some, and that's the reason now that the Midnight Express can come on like they are.
Cornette's so hyper and upset that his face is almost the same color as his red pants.
And you talk about red.
We're talking green in the latter part of April. A whole lot of green. And that's
You're
what these
about
guys...
$1 million.
That's it.
$1 million to the winner of the Jim Crockett Senior Memorial Cup. Boy, I tell you, there's going to be some happy tag team when that's all over.
That's
and
right.
There's going to be 23 of them that are going to be vastly disappointed because it's the winner take all, the $1 million to the Crockett winner.
If you fans just joined us, the top 10 seeds, the World Tag Team Champion, Arn Anderson, Tully Blanchard, number one, the Superpowers, number two, the Road Warriors, number three, Midnight Express, four, Powers of Pain, five, Barry Windham, Lex Luger, six, the Fantastic Seven, the Varsity Club, eight, Sting and Ron Garvin with Magnum TA managing them, the number nine seed, and Paul Jones' second entry, Ivan Koloff and the Rowdy Texan, Dick Murdoch, number 10.
I was going to say, Jim, that's most interesting about those top 10 seeds, Paul Jones. He's got two teams right up there in that top 10 seed.
But there's a lot of other great teams. There's 14 other teams. And what an atomic drop. Fulton is reaching down to the very bottom.
Can he make the tag? He needs it right here. Oh, there's Wayne. Cut him off.
That was a great move. Eaton. That was a great move by Bobby Eaton. That was a great move by Bobby Eaton. Knocking Rogers off the apron.
35. Eaton went flying into the ring to catch Fulton before he got there. He went right on by him to hit Rogers.
Fulton would have made the tag if Bobby Eaton had not knocked Tommy Rogers off the apron. That was a great tag team move by the Midnight Express, especially Bobby Eaton. Oh, yeah, right foot and right to the face.
Boy, I tell you, he's lucky if his nose is not spread all over his face after catching that foot right
can
in the mouth and nose.
Here? He needs to make it.
He does.
He's made the tag, and Tommy Rogers is in the ring, and he is rested, and he is motivated. He is on fire. Drop kick.
All four men in the ring now as they continue to go at it. The Fantastics are returning over the top rope again. Here's Rogers.
Oh, man, all the way up to the concrete on his back. All the way, and remember, Tommy Rogers, the man that's laying on the concrete, I think is the legal man in the ring.
They're going to double-team Fulton as they've got him. Stan's going to hold him up, slams him to the mat. The patented move now to Express. Wait a minute, here comes Rogers. Get him out of the way.
He moved him out of the way, and Bobby Eaton came down, and nobody was there. And wait a minute, Fantastics. What a move. He was in the lights.
The superstars of professional wrestling will gather in the most spectacular wrestling event in history. Clash of the Champions, live and free of charge, 4 p.m. Eastern Sunday.
Okay, thank you very much, Jim Ross. And here they are, the Fantastics. Gentlemen, it was sensational.
Well, I'd like to take this opportunity right off the bat, Mr. Schiavone, to thank all the fans out there that's followed the Fantastics in the past and the ones tonight right there in the ring against the Midnight Express. Jimmy Cornette, you knocked us for a long time before coming to the established NWA, the home of the greatest array of stars in wrestling today. But we just want to prove a point to you, Jimmy. It was no fluke. We beat you guys 1-2-3. And one thing I want to say, we did something to them that they usually don't do. We beat them with their own moves. We're not going to attack you on the mat. We're going to beat you in the air.
I think, Tommy, before you talk, we need to take a look at, once again, how it happened right here on NWA Pro Wrestling. Let's take a look.
Push in the mouth and nose. Here. He needs to make it.
He does.
He's made the tag, and Tommy Rogers is in the ring, and he is rested, and he is motivated. He is on fire. Drop kick.
All four men in the ring now as they continue to go at it. The Fantastics are returning over the top rope again. Oh, Paul Rogers.
Oh, man. Concrete on his back. All the way. And remember, Tommy Rogers, the man that's laying on the concrete, I think is the legal man in the ring.
They're going to double-team Fulton as they've got him. Stan's going to hold him up. Slams him to the mat. The patented move now to Express. Wait a minute. Here comes Rogers. Drug him out of the way.
He moved him out of the way. And Bobby Eaton came down. And nobody was
No doubt, Tommy. It certainly was a gutsy win.
You know, Mr. Schiavone, you know, we've throughout our career, we've dedicated our career to the fans. And we'd just like to thank all the fans that were there tonight and all the ones who are sitting behind them TV screens. We'd just like to thank each and every one of you. We're looking forward to meeting each and every one of you. And just like by myself, you can see these right here, big old smiles. And we hope to continue these big old smiles in the NWA because Bobby and myself are fired up. In 1988, it's going to be great for the Fantastics.
There's no doubt about it, Bobby.
You know, Mr. Schiavone, just like Tommy said, it all sums it up to one thing. If it wasn't for those fans, we wouldn't be standing right there. And if it wasn't for the great people out there, Cornette, you would still be running your mouth. We beat you 1-2-3. Thank you, fans. We love you.
I'd just like to say one more thing, Mr. Schiavone. Jimmy Cornette is the biggest wimp that the Fantastics has ever seen, and I know the people has ever seen. So, Jimmy Cornette, remember when all them people call you a wimp. It's the truth. It's not a lie.
There's no doubt about it. The Fantastics take it right to the Midnight Express right here in the NWA. You're going to be hearing a lot from Bobby Fulton and Tommy Rogers. For Jim Ross, Bob Cotto, I'm Tony Schiavone. Fans, we'll see you next week.